An astronaut from the United Arab Emirates shares a photo of the Philippines taken 400 kilometers above the Earth. Emirati astronaut Sultan Al-Nayadi greeted Filipinos and shared a striking image of the Taal volcano. The snapshot was taken from the orbiting International Space Station. Al-Nayadi noted Taal is one of the smallest volcanoes in the world and the second most active volcano in the Philippines.
Thousands of pro-coup supporters in Niger marched through the capital and attacked the French embassy. The mob set fires outside the embassy's walls and smashed windows in a protest against Niger's former colonial power. France on Sunday cut all development aid to the country and called for the reinstatement of President Mohamed Bazoum, who was ousted last July 26. West Africa's regional bloc also imposed financial and travel restrictions against the new military leaders, vowing to use force if Bazoum is not reinstated within a week. The Philippine Trade Department expects President Marcos's Malaysia trip to generate 100,000 jobs. Assistant Secretary Glenn Peñaranda says at least 9 companies have expressed their interest to invest in the Philippines. He says most of these investment pledges may materialize in the next 2 years.
Variety of sectors, no? At saka lahat ito ay aligns naman sa mga priorities natin. For example, merong interest sa construction and infrastructure, meron sa aviation and aviation services, at saka yung related na logistics, meron din of course sa mga digital services. At saka mahalaga yung sa agriculture, no, na talagang pinagbibigyan pansin.
Economists project Philippine inflation in July eased for a 6th straight month, with some even seeing headline inflation falling below 5% from June's 5.4%. ING Bank cites favorable base effects, while expecting core inflation, which excludes volatile food and energy prices, will also ease to 7% from 7.4%. Meanwhile, Goldman Sachs cites higher vegetable and fish prices that are partially offset by lower electricity prices. The Philippine Central Bank has been on pause after pulling the trigger on 425 basis points of rate hikes to 5.25%, the most aggressive in the region, to fight inflation. The official reading for the July inflation rate is set to be released on August 4, and the BSP's next policy meeting is on August 17.
Transport groups are appealing for help as fuel prices soar. Jeepney Group Pasang Basa says they will ask transport regulators to approve of surge pricing during rush hour traffic in Metro Manila. Aside from this, jeepney drivers and operators are seeking the government's assistance through a fuel subsidy. They also plan to start talks on a possible fare hike. With tomorrow's increase, a net rollback for diesel has been wiped out.
Bukas nga ay meron kaming meeting kay Chairman Jojo Guadis, at gusto ko kasama ko ang Magnificent Seven, gusto kong buhayin at yung aming tinatawag na ipinail namin surcharge na 1 peso kada rush hour. Magmumula ito ng alas 5 ng umaga hanggang alas 8 at alas 5 ng hapon hanggang alas 8 ng gabi. At dito siguro sa panawagan namin ito ay mapagbibigyan na kami ng ating LTFRB.
Local motorists better gas up as a big-time oil price hike takes effect on Tuesday. Diesel prices will see the biggest jump at 3 pesos and 50 centavos per liter. Kerosene prices will increase by 3 pesos and 25 centavos per liter, while a liter of gasoline will cost 2 pesos and 10 centavos more. Industry players still attribute the price hike to the ongoing oil output cut of 1 million barrels per day by OPEC. Expectations of tightening U.S. crude supply also contributed to the increase in pump prices.
The European Union to launch a digital economy package for the Philippines this year. European Commission President Ursula von der Leyen says they want to help the Philippines become a digital hub in Southeast Asia. She says the assistance will include the deployment and development of 5G networks and cybersecurity training. The digital package comes as the Marcos administration pushes for the digitalization of government services.
We are also working on a possible extension on a submarine cable that we plan to build between the European via the Arctic to Japan, and this cable could go all the way down to Southeast Asia, and we believe that it could go via the Philippines. That would give you a strategic position on an infrastructure that could be instrumental both for your prosperity and national security.
The European Union also commits to support the Philippines' claims in the South China Sea. The regional bloc says it is ready to share information and build the capacity of the country's coast guard. European Commissioner President Ursula von der Leyen made this statement in Malacanang as she describes Manila's arbitral win against Beijing as legally binding.
We are ready to strengthen the cooperation with the Philippines on maritime security in the region by sharing information, conducting threat assessment, and building the capacity of your National Coast Watch Center and your Coast Guard. Security in Europe and security in the Indo-Pacific is indivisible. Challenges to the rules-based order in our interconnected world affect all of us. Our societies pay through higher energy bills, higher food costs,